Hey Sweetwater, my name is OP, Artist Relations Manager for Serato. I'm here to talk to you about a really exciting new product we have called Serato Sample. Serato Sample is our powerful and intuitive new sampler plugin for producers, available in VST and AU formats. Serato Sample allows you to chop up samples using Serato DJ's famous cue point workflow. It helps you find samples, detect the key, and allows you to key shift your samples. It also has the famous pitch and time algorithm built in, giving you the best time stretching quality in the market. For each cue point that you make inside a Serato sample, you can affect each pad individually with per pad parameters, including reverse, level, filter, attack, release, key shifting, and also time stretching. You can trigger sample pads using your computer's keyboard or any MIDI hardware. Serato Sample is a plug-in instrument that records as MIDI into your host DAW. You can either record yourself triggering cue points or paint them into the DAW's MIDI piano roll. So in this video, I'm going to walk you through some of the steps of Serato Sample. For this example, I'm going to be using Logic, but Serato Sample officially supports Ableton, FL Studio, Machine, and works with other DAWs that support VSTs and AUs. I'm going to take you through the Find Samples Autoset feature. Officially, Serato Sample has four autoset modes. These are instant ways to help you come up with ideas for your production. For this example, I'm going to create a MIDI track in Logic and load up an instance of Serato Sample with the sample inside. When I press the Find Samples button inside a Serato Sample, 16 cue points are automatically created, which I can use to record a MIDI performance with. I can adjust the parameters per pad and change and shape the sound using level, filter, attack, release, and so on and so forth. So I'm going to load a file into Serato Sample to use. I can either press Load File or I can drag a file from anyone on the computer into Serato Sample. When I press load, I'll find a track really quickly and I'll load it up. The first thing that you'll notice is that there is a waveform that's here that's in color. This will give you full color spectrum in regards to frequency, so highs, lows, and mids. Darker colors will represent the lows. The kind of lighter colors will represent mids and highs. You can scroll through the track easily by being able to use your mouse to go across it, or you can scrub to get to the exact point that you want to in the song to be able to work with. When you load up the song, it gives you the key of the song automatically because it has pitch and time built in. So here for this example, the track is in G minor. It also gives you the BPM of the song, but because Serato Sample is working with sync, you will see that it's going to match up to the BPM of your host DAW. So for this example, inside of Logic, I have it set to 108, and inside of Serato Sample, it's also set to 108 as well. I can look at the key in a couple of different ways. If I hold down the Option button and I press the key, I can change it to be in various looks for key. So if you're used to working with the circle of fifths, you can look at it in the Camelot wheel way, or if you want to look at it in regular key, you can look at it that way as well. You can also change the key by using the buttons to change it up or down by semitone. So I'm going to take you through the Find Samples Autoset feature. Serato Sample has four autoset modes. These are instant ways for you to come up with ideas for your production. So as example, I created a MIDI track in Logic. I loaded up an instance of Serato Sample and I put a track inside of it. When I press Find Samples, which is at the bottom left corner of the plugin, it will search through the song and find 16 cue points that I can use for a MIDI performance. So in this example, I have 16 different cue points that it's given me. I like one of them, so I can favorite it by pressing the star for that pad. A star now appears on the first pad, and now I can clear all the rest of them, and if I want to, I can press Find Samples again and find others to be able to work with. In this example, though, I'm going to actually take the same note and I'm going to add different pads to it. So I'm going to press the keys going along. And now per pad, I'm going to make changes to them by doing some key shifting. Now let's record a MIDI sequence with that. Now that I have the sequence set, I can go through and do some things. If I do select all, I can now affect all the pads together. So if I want to now filter all them together, and also change the release, or even reverse. And maybe this is too fast, so I can slow it down. Changing the global BPM will allow me to now have all of them stay together in time because of the pitch and time algorithm built inside of it. Serato Sample has the best time stretching audio quality in the market. It's powered by pitch and time. So as you've seen in this example, I've taken a track, I've loaded it into Serato Sample, I've set up some cue points, and I've recorded a MIDI sequence. Now with that MIDI sequence recorded, I've been able to change the BPM inside of Logic. And with that being changed, now I can time stretch this to make it go faster or slower, and you don't hear any digital glitches or pops. Everything still sounds the same, and it's in the same key. Again, this is the power of pitch and time allowing you to be able to do this. Also, to show you the power of pitch and time, I'm now going to change the BPM down to about 20 BPMs. Here you can see it's still playing in the same key, still sounds very, very clean without any digital glitches or pops. Again, because of the power of pitch and time. I'm going to speed it back up again. I can also take Serato Sample out of sync, leave the BPM as it's set inside of Logic, but then have it play different here inside of Serato Sample. So here I'm going to drag this down to 20 BPM so you can hear the difference. I can also achieve this by half timing or double timing for the global BPM inside of Serato Sample. Serato Sample also has keyboard mode, which will allow you to choose one cue point, select it into keyboard mode, and have it spread across 88 keys so you can play it like a keyboard. So here, if I select the key that I want it to be, and I press this little keyboard icon, this will now put this into keyboard mode. Changing the octave, I can go up higher. Or lower. Serato Sample has two playback modes, mono and poly. Mono means triggering one cue point will cut the playback of the last. This is the same as triggering cue points inside of Serato DJ. Poly mode allows you to play back multiple cue points at once. This is great for overlapping cue points, for example, when you're triggering your drum hits. So for example, I have some drums here in this setup for Serato Sample. So in this instance, if I try to play both of these at the same time, they'd be blocked off because it's in mono mode. Poly mode will allow me to play them on top of each other. Poly mode also allows you to play your samples like a synth. So for example, I turned on keyboard mode and I have a cue point set and I have it turned into poly mode. So now I can actually play chords and melodies using poly mode and keyboard mode. And I can record all that as a MIDI sequence and build a beat out of it. So that's a quick rundown of Serato Sample. If you have any questions about Serato Sample or any Serato products, make sure you call your Sweetwater sales engineer to find out more.